Hello and welcome to this brief tutorial on how to add your research to Pure. To start, go to bristol.ac.uk/pure and that will take you to the page I'm on now. From this page, click the Pure login button. You will be asked to sign in using your single sign-on credentials and that will take you into the Pure interface. Yours might look a little different from mine. Yours should have a list of your publications there that you can edit if you already have some in Pure. To get them into Pure, you go up to the top right corner here to add content. You'll see here there are some commonly used types that you can select from. But we can also go to Research Output, Contribution to Journal, Article. And this is your basic Pure record that you'll need to fill in. If you're pressed for time, you only need to fill in the red starred fields like this one, but it helps to get as much information in there as possible. So we're going to click Peer Reviewed here. We need to record the acceptance date for all journal articles that are added to Pure, and that's because of the requirements of some of the policies involved. And so to do that, we go to this drop down here, and we select Accepted / Impress. And we put the acceptance date in here. You can add other dates as well by clicking Add Publication Status and Date. So say we know the date it was put on the publisher's webpage. We can put that in here. And click Create, and that will add the date to the record. For the publication information, make sure you put the title in. And you can add a subtitle down here. And make sure you put an abstract in. You can just paste that in there. If you know page numbers, you can put them down here, but the point you're supposed to be depositing at the point of acceptance, you're unlikely to know these, but it is possible to come back and add them later. We do also update the repository with information when we get it. So your name should already appear here as an author, but if it doesn't, you can go to Add Person and add your details here. And you can do this for your co-authors as well. So if they're an internal person at the University of Bristol, then use the search function here. And that should find the person you're looking for. And click Create. And they'll appear in the record. If you want to add someone from outside the university, go to Add Person again. But this time, change to Create External Person. And then put their details in there. If your authors have come out in the wrong order and you need to reorder them, there are little arrows to the side here. And if you just click the arrow, it will update the list and move that person up. So now we need to add the journal, which is done down here. And you just click the Add Journal button. And then you search for the journal you're looking for. As you can see, we have BMJ open here, so we'll select that. If you know the volume and issue number, you can add them in here. But again, at the point of acceptance, you're unlikely to know them, so you can skip them for now. Below that, we have the opportunity to add documents, DOIs, and URLs. Now, this is where you add your author's accepted manuscript. So the author's accepted manuscript is the version of the file that we're allowed to add for almost all publishers, and it's what's required for most open access policies. It's the version after you've gone through all the peer review changes, but before the publisher has added any of their formatting or logos or things like that. It's probably the last Word document that you sent your publisher. So to actually add a file, go to Add Document DOI / URL. And click Add a File. And then click into this box and select the file from your computer. And once the screen is refreshed, go to Document Version and set that to Accepted Author Manuscript. And set Access to the Electronic Version to Open. Many publications do require an embargo, but the Open Access team in the library check every record that has a file attached and make sure that we set up any embargoes that are required, so you don't need to worry about that. Once you're done there, click Create, And the file will appear on your record. So there's one more thing you need to know, and that's down here under relations, you can link this record in Pure to other records. Where this is most important is for projects. Projects links your work to your funded research project, and that can be very helpful getting the information out of Pure again later for reporting to your funder and things like that. It should bring up a list automatically of funding projects that you're associated with, but if it doesn't, you can search in this box and find it. So we're going to select the Protect study here. As you see, it comes up on the record. You can also link to other research outputs, activities, data sets, anything else that you might have added to Pure. You can link them all together here, and that will provide links and explore Bristol Research. Once you're happy with your record, go down to the Save button and click. That will then send the record to the Open Access team. They'll check it to make sure that the accepted manuscript is appropriately embargoed as required by the publisher, and they'll add in any other data they find along the way as well. So that's the basics of adding a record to Pure. If you have any questions, please contact the Library Research Support Team, who will be happy to help. Thank you.